We go back to our top story now out of Central America in Guatemala, where over 160 people have died after Thursday's mudslide there, one of the worst natural disasters to hit Guatemala in decades. Our correspondent for Central America, Gerardo Torres, is following the latest. Gerardo, we know there are hundreds of people still missing there, so the question is, do they expect that any of those people could still be found alive?
Hello, Tony. Today is the last day that the rescue team has put themselves so they can find people that are still alive. There are still 300 people that are considered missing, disappeared. 161 have been declared dead. The rescue team goes of Guatemala with the help of the Mexican rescue team and people from, well, from the community that are looking for their family members are working harder today. We're working extra hours permanently since Thursday. And today, as the rescue team said, that after the work that they could do today, there would be very low possibilities that the 300 people that have disappeared can still find alive. They can't declare them dead. They can't declare them until they find them. But because of the conditions of the land and the conditions that they can be in the mudslide and the pressure, it will be unlikely that they could still find people alive tomorrow in the rescue operation that tomorrow will happen.
And what about the people who were lucky enough to survive this, Gerardo? Many of them have been left completely without homes. What's the government and other response teams doing to help those people?
Well, there are few answers from the government at this point. We're talking about at least 100 families that were taken away during the first 2 days. They have been put around in spaces around the community, especially in schools and others. But this is just a temporary situation. They won't be able to be kept for longer than probably a couple of weeks. People are still working, looking for their families. Many of them are still living in the new area. But those that lost their houses still don't have a certainty from the government.
All right, Gerardo Torres reporting on what is an absolute tragic situation in Guatemala. Gerardo, thanks for the latest.